Our new release is iOS 14. Wouldn't it be great if there were a way to organize all of those apps without doing a thing? Well, this year we're doing just that with something called the App Library. It's a new space at the end of your home screen pages that automatically organizes all your apps in one simple and easy to navigate view. So here in App Library, getting to the app I'm looking for is really easy. Up at the top, I have the search field, and I get all my apps organized from A to Z. Now over here on the upper left, I have suggestions. It uses on-device intelligence to show me the apps that I'm likely to need next. And on the right is recently added. And below are intelligently curated categories. Next, let's turn to widgets. To start, they're more beautiful and data rich. And we're introducing different sizes so you can choose one that best fits your needs. So check this out. I'm just gonna tap and hold on the weather widget and I can drag it out of today view and onto my home screen. And watch as I move it around, the apps just dance out of the way to make space for my new widget. The gallery is a great place to explore widgets. Now, when I tap on one, I can actually page through all of the different sizes available. With the Smart Stack, I can easily swipe through widgets to pick just the one I want for the moment. But what's really cool is that the Smart Stack can actually do this for me automatically. So in the morning, I can get my news briefing. Throughout the day, find out when I have a meeting coming up. And in the evening, I might get a summary of my activity for the day. Next, we're also bringing Picture in Picture to iPhone. So you can access apps on your iPhone while watching video or talking on a FaceTime call. Now check this out. When I swipe to go home, the video automatically goes into Picture in Picture right over the home screen. And when I launch another app, like Notes, I can keep watching. Now I can drag the picture to another part of the screen. If I want to make it bigger, I can even pinch to zoom. And as I move between applications, it stays with me. And what's cool is I can also swipe it to the side and the audio keeps playing when it's off screen. Another iconic experience that's getting a major update is Siri. So this year, we've completely redesigned the Siri experience with a new compact design. Siri pops up at the bottom of the screen and instantly launches the app. Or if you ask for information, like the weather, results appear at the top of the screen, just like a notification.
Siri's always been great for getting information and now has over 20 times more facts than just 3 years ago. This year, you can now ask Siri to send an audio message and Siri will start recording. When communicating with someone in another language, Siri can help with translations. This year, we're expanding to support many new language pairs. We're introducing a new app called Translate. It can work completely offline, keeping your conversations private. Using advanced on-device machine learning and the powerful neural engine, you can translate your text and voice between any combination of these 11 languages. And just turn the phone to landscape to open conversation mode. We've designed a side-by-side view that's easy for two people to know which side to follow in the conversation with just a single microphone button because the app intelligently detects the language spoken and shows translation on the correct side of the screen.
Next up, messages.
Let's get started with conversations. So we are introducing a new way to let you stay connected to your most important conversations by letting you pin them at the top of your list so you can always get to them. And you can see messages as they come in with a beautiful animation on the pin. Next, let's talk about expressing yourself with Memoji. In iOS 14, we're adding even more ways to create your look with over 20 new hair and headwear styles to let you reflect your hobby, profession, and personality. We've also added something that's even more relevant today, face coverings. And we're adding more age options too. And now we have three brand new Memoji stickers that let you send a hug, a fist bump, or even a blush to your friends. Last, let's chat about groups. First, we're adding inline replies that let you reply directly to a specific message. You can view replies in the full conversation, or you can view them as their own thread so you can focus in on the specific topic. With mentions, you can just type someone's name to direct a message to them. And now you have the ability to only be notified when you're mentioned in the group conversation. We have an all new design for how groups appear. It lets you see all the members of your group where the most recently active people are shown largest. And for the first time ever, you can create a unique visual identity for your group by setting a group photo, or customizing your group's look with an emoji. You know who's most recently commented in the group because their photo will appear around the outside of the pin.
Next, let's take a look at features that help us while we're out and about, starting with maps. We're excited to announce we're bringing our new map to more countries later this year, including the UK, Ireland, and Canada.
In iOS 14, the Maps team will be working with some of the world's most trusted brands to offer amazing guides. Guides for great places to eat, shop, meet friends, or explore in cities around the world. We're adding a dedicated cycling option to Maps, which allows users to ride their bike along bike lanes, paths, and roads. We'll even let you know if you have a steep passage coming up or if you'll need to carry your bike up the stairs. With iOS 14, we're bringing cycling to New York City, LA, the San Francisco Bay Area, along with a number of cities in China like Shanghai and Beijing. We're also introducing EV routing. With iOS 14, Maps will track your current charge and factor in things like elevation and weather to automatically add charging stops along your route. We're adding congestion and green zones to Maps to easily see where they are, along with alternate routing options. In addition, drivers in China can securely store their license plate number on their iPhone, and Maps will let them know which days they can enter congested city centers based on that number.
And now, on to CarPlay. We have new wallpaper options, and we're adding support for new categories of CarPlay apps: parking, EV charging, and quick food ordering.
I'm excited to introduce a digital version of Car Keys. Now you can leave your keys at home and unlock and start your car with your iPhone. And the very first car to support this will be the new 2021 BMW 5 Series. Digital keys have security benefits. They live in the secure element of your iPhone. And if it goes missing, you can turn off your keys remotely via iCloud. And you can share from wherever you are with iMessage.
Now, let's turn to the App Store. An app clip is a small part of an app. It's light and fast and easy to discover, so you can quickly get what you need right when you need it. They start with this card, which quickly pops up, and with just a tap, you can launch the app clip. The best way to discover app clips will be with a new Apple-designed app clip code. So when you see one, you'll know that there's an app clip waiting for you. They incorporate both a visual code and NFC, so you tap on them or scan them with the camera to bring up an app clip. And that's iOS 14.
Let's take a look at some of the enhancements to iPadOS. The first thing that you'll notice are the same redesigned widgets that you saw in iOS 14. And this year, we're making it even easier to browse and organize your photos with an all-new sidebar. With just a tap of this button, I can reveal the sidebar with all the core functionality of the app in a single location. I can easily drag a photo to the sidebar and then just drop it to add it to an album. We've brought this sidebar to many apps across iPadOS. We've also streamlined the toolbars, adding new drop-down menus that consolidate functions into a single, easy-to-access button. The sidebar in Music makes it easy to move between views. I can quickly jump between the new Listen Now and my playlists. And once I start playing a song, I can bring up the brand new full-screen player, where I can see rich album art, transport controls, and lyrics all in one single view.
The new compact Siri design that you heard about in iOS 14 is especially useful on iPad. Results appear at the bottom right corner, allowing you to easily reference the app while using Siri. Now an incoming call is presented with a compact notification that doesn't take you out of context. And you can simply tap to answer or flick it away to dismiss. So we've redesigned search with a new compact design. You can start a search from anywhere, like the home screen or over any app. And search now makes navigating to your favorite websites just as easy as launching an app. Just type a few letters and the top hit will take you right to Safari. Our customers tell us that once they have an Apple Pencil in their hand, they don't want to put it away. So this year we're bringing Scribble to iPad.